is Max and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk to you guys a little bit about designer backpacks. So if you're interested in what that is all about, just keep watching. Hey guys, long time no see. I know it's been a while since I've been here. I have quite a few things going on in my personal life, so I'm not really gonna drag it out and discuss all of that here. I just popped in today because I told a few people that I would come back and do some videos. So I had some extra time tonight, so I decided to pop in and do a video. Backpacks are fashionable and functional. And in my lifestyle, I need that at times. I mean, a lot of times I make decisions based off of fashion in my wardrobe when it comes to me buying particular bags. But the lifestyle that I'm in now, you know, with my health and what I need to carry for work and where I live and all those things, a backpack comes in handy. I know you guys know that last year I was really preaching the fanny pack trend, and that works fabulous for me in the summertime, but I live in a climate where it's cold and we're wearing layers and bulky things, and a fanny pack just doesn't work for me that way because as a plus size woman, I can't do it crossbody like that. I have to do it around the waist. So I found that backpacks probably are the best for me during this time. And I'm loving them, you guys. I'm just absolutely loving them. What I wanna say is the word of today is gonna be versatility, because I have worn these backpacks casual with athleisure, and I've also worn them dressy. And to be, just keep it real, the people in my office, they're wearing backpacks and they're wearing them with their, you know, professional clothing, and it looks awesome on them. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about that. I don't know if you guys watch runway shows or anything, but Givenchy did their haute couture and they showed backpacks with that. And that's like, you know, haute couture is like the design of all designs. And she actually showed, because they have a new creative director who is a woman, and she actually showed these huge backpacks that have the bows on them. And I thought that was really fabulous. I mean, it was different, but it was nice to see that silhouette displayed in a way that we haven't seen before. And I love when they do that. I love when they take a silhouette, you know, that we have, you know, are used to seeing, but we're used to seeing it in one particular way, and then they take it and they transform it into something different. I'm here for that. I mean, I know we love our flat bags and we love our totes, but I'm here for other silhouettes. I mean, other silhouettes that I still think could be classic pieces. I love that. I love to see them being transformed into other directions. Now, I'm gonna show you my collection today, and I'm gonna talk a little bit about what I like about them, what I don't like about them, and then I'm gonna share with you some ones that I think are great designer backpacks that I think are wonderful to add to a collection that I don't own. However, I think they're wonderful and they may show up in my collection someday soon. Vuitton is the one that kind of got me back into backpacks, I will say. I mean, I kind of was into them, but not as much as I was until after, well, I'll say between this and MCM. I'm gonna start with Louis Vuitton. Now, this is the Palm Springs PM backpack. And this backpack I've had maybe 2 years, maybe 3 years, 2 or 3 years I've had it. I've had it for a while. And it's held up fine. I mean, there hasn't been any problems with wear or tear or anything like this. And this is a piece that I usually style basically with casual wear, but I've been known to like put it on with, you know, black leather pants, a turtleneck sweater, basically what I'm wearing, Chloe Susanna boots, things like that. And it works out fine. So if I want to kind of dress it up for, you know, like, downtown date night, you know, because I live in a downtown area, this works great. It also works great for me running errands because I could load it up for the things. And these straps are very soft, you guys. So if you're going to be lugging around quite a few things, these are great. This is a great backpack because of the straps. What I will say about it is I hate the zipper because it sticks all the time, and I've had it for a long time, like I said, and I've used it a lot. So it's still stiff and it gets caught a little bit with this lip hanging over. So that's one of the drawbacks to it. This is a functional pocket. I know on the mini size of it, of the Palm Springs, that pocket probably isn't functional, but this one is. Other than that, I think it's a really great piece. I like this canvas because it's all weather. So if you live in climate like I do, you're able to, you know, use it in the snow, in the cold. And the great thing about it, ladies, if your arms are big like mine and you struggle with totes, some of the, like the Neverfull, and you are wearing thick coats with layers. This right here, I don't care how big your damn arm is, this will go over it, and I love that about it. You can also carry it top handle like this. And for as much as I put into it, like I said, I never feel the weight of it. And where I live, I don't worry about pickpockets or anything like that, so this is something that I can put on my back. I usually do it on one shoulder, you know, but if I need to be hands-free, I will definitely put it on my back. So this is the first one that's in my collection. And if you're looking to add it, I'm gonna link all of these below that I can find, so you could get the price points, because I'm sure the price is totally different from when I originally bought it. But anyway, that's the first one. Now, this one is my Palm Springs mini backpack. This was the Stark Studded backpack, and this is in metallic. Now, I've had this probably three years, and I got this when the Palm Springs mini first dropped. It was impossible to get it, so I kind of looked around for something else that I would like, and this one came up, and I loved it. I like the metallic. I really, really do. I like the mini backpack trend. It is cute. I usually do it more crossbody than I do as a backpack. It holds a decent amount. What I like it is the versatility of this bag, because you're able to do top handle, you're able to do it as a belt bag, and you're also able to do crossbody as well as, like I said, a backpack. And then these two little pockets here on the side are functional. They're great for just putting a chapstick or a lipstick in it or something like that. This is a functional pocket. The inside is big, you know, just like the Palm Springs Mini, you can fit, you know, quite a bit in this backpack. Pretty much every one of the backpacks is pretty generous. But this is cool. This works great as a fashionable piece, and it also works great as a functional piece. Like, you know, I have worn it with a silver ball, like a gunmetal ball gown skirt before, so I've worn it in evening wear, and that was pretty cool. I mean, because these kind of look like jewels at night, so I think this is fun. I know it comes in all different colors. I've seen it in like a really pretty light pink, I've seen it in red, I've seen it in the traditional cognac color, I've seen it in black, so it comes in a lot of colors. I've seen it in gold and in the silver, so I will try to link some of them below. And this is a really great price point if you're into designer, like luxury bags, and you want a luxury backpack. I think this is a really great starting price point. I want to say it was, you know, around $600-$700 mark, so that's a great intro price point for a bag like this. So I want to talk to you guys a little bit about this one here. This one, and you would have to probably get this one from off of a pre-loved website, because this is a Henri Bendel piece. And Henri Bendel went out of business and they closed, and the only thing I got, guys, was this backpack, because I had it before and my niece got it from me, so I rebought it again, and that's pretty much the only thing I bought. I didn't really see anything that kind of tickled my fancy, because I kind of still have quite a few things from them. But this one right here is great. This is that nylon material. It reminds you of the Burberry backpacks as well as the Prada backpacks. So it's a really sturdy material. It's trimmed in the Saffiano leather. It has tons and tons and tons of storage in it. And I like it because of the gold. You can make this dressy, you can make this casual. This definitely is one that'll fit my laptop. If it's, you know, it's definitely one that I can haul off to work. And I, since I've added it back into my bag wardrobe, I have been using it for work. I have the little Chloe Susanna boots, and I love wearing this with that. I think this looks cool. You can also remove these straps, and you can change it into a shoulder bag. You can make it into a crossbody bag, and of course, it's top handle. This right here is not a functional lock, guys. This is just a decorative piece, but it's huge. This bag offers, I'm gonna zip open it for you because I've got some storage in it, but it's big. It's big as all get out in there. It's got tons of compartments, tons of space. So if you're somebody that doesn't want to carry like, and you can get away with a bag like this, and you don't want to carry like a big tote or something like that, this is a great alternative. Like I said, you can just slap it on your back and it works fabulous. And look how dressy and chic it looks in black. I love that in black. I think this is a really, really cool piece. As well as these pockets too are functional, guys. These are functional pockets. Okay, so another one that I got was this metallic gold one here. And this one is from, and this one here is from Louis Vuitton. This is the Lock Me BB backpack. and it's in this metallic gold with the silver hardware, and this is all leather. This is one of those mini backpack crays too, so you can also do pretty much the same with it being top handle. You could make it into a shoulder straps because these straps are removable. You can also make a crossbody. This one has quite a bit of storage in it. I usually wear it with the chain from HRH on it to kind of give it a little bit of an edge. It has a microfiber like lining in it, and it has one pocket. This is a really cool piece. I've worn this quite a bit. I've got some sneakers that match this, but I also have like a Louis Vuitton heel. I think it's called the Madison heel, and I've worn it with that before with a black suit. I've worn it dressy, I've worn it casual, and it's a pretty good investment piece for me. Now, I know they have this backpack in the larger size, black with the silver hardware, and I love it. I love it a lot. And that has been kind of, I've been on the lookout for that. I've kind of had my eye on it. I haven't decided if I want to add it or not, but I do love it. I love it with the silver hardware, and I love this shape. I really, really do, and I think it'd look great. You know, with some of my professional pieces of clothing, or semi-casual, however, business casual, however I decide. But again, I will link, I don't know if you can still get gold because this might have been a limited edition color. I will check some pre-loved websites. Guys, I think that they've continued making it, and I know I've seen it in black, and I've seen it in like with like Lock Me little like decals or whatever they call them on there on the bag, which I think is cute too. But I'll link it below so you can get all the information out of it. So this is a really cute one too. Chanel. This is my Chanel Gabrielle small backpack. And this backpack is 2 years old. I've had it for a while. And I know I did a wear and tear on it. And I'm gonna show you guys, because I know people are always concerned about the wear and tear of the bag and what it's gonna look like. And this is my 2 year old bag. So as you can see, it's in perfect condition. And I've used it a lot. I've used it a ton. It's constantly on rotation. To be honest with you, I don't wear it a ton as a backpack. I do sometimes, but not a lot. Usually I wear it as a crossbody. And the reason why I don't wear it as a backpack, guys, is because you can't just use one strap to put on your shoulder. You have to do it both straps on one side. Just because the way the strap is made, there isn't a stopper to keep it from pulling the chain all the way through. So that's one of the drawbacks of this. What I will say about the Gabrielle collection is I've noticed in some of the bags that's part of the Gabrielle, the design has slightly changed from when it originally dropped, and they've made some improvements on it. So I've learned my lesson on that, that I don't necessarily need to be first when the bag drops. I can wait for the second round, you know, just to see if they've made any improvements or anything like that. But this one isn't bad, it's fine. I don't think they've made a ton of improvements on this one. I think it's more of the Gabrielle hobo. I know they had that awful seam in the front of the first edition, and then the newer editions, the seams are on the side, which look a lot better. But as far as styling this, because it's this distressed leather, with the smooth leather, this looks like a really cool edgy bag. And so it looks fabulous with dresses, and it looks really cool with your suits. There is a skirt from Banana Republic that I have, and I'm gonna put it up for you guys to see. And I wear that with black scrunchy high heel boots, and I wear it with a turtleneck, and it is my husband loves that outfit on me. And I love like wearing it with pleated skirts like that. I also love wearing it. There was like a Zara dress that I had that kind of looks Dior inspired. I wear that with it. There's a lot of cool things that I think this bag adds a lot to. I love it in this black color. I know every single collection that comes out, they do it in, you know, different colorways. So I've seen pink, and I've seen white, I've seen beige, I've seen a ton of colors that this particular bag came in. I am a fan of the black. I know it also comes in the white. I have the white with the hobo Gabrielle, but I'm a fan of this little bucket here in black. It's very cute and dainty. It's light. I wouldn't put a lot of weight in this because these chains will dig on you guys. But if you definitely want a bag that could go either way, could go dressy or could go casual, and it's not really super heavy. And in terms of price points for Chanel, I think this one is probably, well, when I got it, it was on the lower end. The price has probably went up since then. but it wasn't like a super, like, they're all expensive, but it wasn't as high as hell the way Chanel's prices is today. So this right here, I think, is a really cool addition to your wardrobe. In terms of black backpacks, let me talk to you guys a little bit about that. Because I know I showed you this one right here, right? With the black and gold, right? And some people are just really not into nylon. And there is one that I like that's black and gold that is by Ferragamo. And I love that backpack. It has, I'm gonna put a picture up for you guys. And I have it on my wish list as a leather backpack I would like to add for next year for winter. But I love it. I like I said, a hefty bag wardrobe because these are my accessories that are making my outfits look different. And if I wear this one like all year long, maybe next year I might want something a little different. So I definitely looked at the Ferragamo one and I love that one. And the price point is absolutely fabulous on here. And this is my Urban Spirit backpack by Chanel in the large size. This is the calfskin, and this is what it looks like. And this was a gift from my hubby. And you guys have probably seen a million one of these. My book is in here and my dust bag is in here. But it just has the zipper pocket, I think, in there. And it's Chanel, and it has a slip pocket in front of it. And this is Chanel made in Italy. Now this is from the fall collection that just came before cruise. So you can probably still find this. I will list the style numbers below. I know I've seen some of this red on resale, like pre-loved sites. And I think that's a great place to get these kind of backpacks. The prices, you can get a good deal on them. And I think that is probably where, if I want to get another one, I will. And I was looking at the black and gold to get in this in the leather, but then I saw the Ferragamo and I'm like, I like that one better. And because I like the size of this and the style of this, I was either trying to decide between the black with the silver and the chevron, or like I said, the black and the gold. But I think the black and the gold is gonna come from Ferragamo. Now, what I love totally about this is that I can fit like my iPad in here. I can fit, you know, a lot of work materials and things that I need. It fits awesome over my thick coats. It's great over one shoulder. I love this pop of color. This is like a dark red, you guys. And I've worn this, I wore this with a gray pantsuit. I also have started like picking out things for my spring wardrobe. And I bought, oh my God, what is it called? A boiler suit that I think is so beautiful from Banana Republic. I'm gonna put a picture up for you guys. And it's in that light pink, and I wanna do the pink against this. You guys know I'm huge on pink and red being mixed together. And I'm gonna do that in the springtime together with a trench coat with this, because this is gonna stay on rotation. This is really cool. This hasn't been in my wardrobe that long. It's probably been in my wardrobe like around Christmas. Well, yeah, it was for Christmas. So around Christmas it came into my wardrobe. But yes, so I'm gonna do it for spring and with the pink. And I'm gonna do it. Of course, I've been wearing it with black, and I've been wearing it. I have like a chunky, thick white sweater that's like this. I've been doing it. It looks great against tan. This is a really, really cool. Urban Spirit backpacks are just to die for. What I also love, if this price point is not in, if this bag is not in your price point, guys, there's one that I like, because you guys know, I think the last time I talked to you guys, I was telling you I needed a cream bag. And I found a cream bag, which I got for, anyway, I found a cream bag. If you follow me on Instagram, you know what I'm talking about. But I wanted a casual, another one for casual. And there, Coach has this backpack, right? And it is gorgeous, gorgeous. And if I was to get that for one of my Mother's Day, birthday gifts, I wouldn't be mad at all. But it's in a light cream color. It's pretty big because they have a large and a small. And it's kind of the same setup, except the leather, the pattern of the leather is different. It's like lined, but it has a chain and it has the straps and it has the big C here. And I'm totally, totally begging for that one. So if you see me with that one in a couple days, you know why. I'm so sure I'm gonna get it because I already bought the shoes to match it. So you know how I am about shoes and bags. But yes, that is totally one. And I'm like here for that cream from Coach. I think Coach's backpack is just as beautiful as this one. I love this one. This is one of my favorites. So, like I said, these are really cool pieces to add. to your collection if you don't have it. If you were thinking about, you know, maybe a backpack is too young for you, or I'm not sure, it kind of goes with my aesthetic, I would say give it a try. It's a really good, I don't want to call it a trend, because to me, I think a backpack could be a classic piece. I know my husband has always worn a backpack, and the city that I live in, you see them all the time. But that's my demographics based on my lifestyle. So you have to look around and see, you know, one, what your personal style is, two, what your lifestyle is, and if it kind of fits with your aesthetic. And for me, it fits. You know, I like stuff that's kind of masculine but feminine. I like stuff that's slightly edgy, but, you know, a little touch of class with it. And what could be classier than Chanel backpacks? Nothing. Nothing could be, except for maybe that Coach one. From my mouth to God's ears. But yes, definitely. So for you guys tonight, thanks so much for watching. Hopefully I won't disappear for that long next time. You know, y'all, my life just been a mess. I'm just gonna keep it real. It's just been a mess. And I'm trying to get it back together. I'm trying. I gotta get back refocused and all that other stuff, but I'm trying. And what's it? That's it. Peace.